next on the track is the women 10,000 metres. What happened to the Kenyans in the steeplechase? They failed to get the bronze.
Disaster, isn't it? The last time they did that was when Mark Rowlands from Britain won the bronze in Seoul in 1988.
Yes, I remember.
They only got first and second then, and first, second and third in Barcelona, and one and two today.
Yeah, but something of a turn up, do you think?
It was, yeah. I mean, in normal circumstances, Kip Tanui, you would have expected to have won it, and I'm sure in his form last year he would have done. But Joseph Keita really was a threat, and the amazing thing was that Lambruschini was allowed to get back up to them, and I think that was ominous, because three or four laps out, it looked like Kip Tanui was going to go and really wind it up, but it never happened. And Keita was quite happy to sit in second place. And at this point, really, Lambruschini had every chance of winning it because he's got a great last lap finish. And all the normal points when Kip Tanui really begins to put his foot down and run away, it just didn't happen. He looked very flat today by his own standards. And you know, I'm wondering, because he's sort of involved with Keita in terms of training, whether Kip Tanui was almost happy just to take the pace and help Keita along. It's difficult to imagine because Kip Tanui desperately wanted to win. Mm-hmm. But it never looked as if he could really turn it on at all. And even now, well, he's obviously trying really hard to hold Keita off. But Kip Tanui at his best would even win that sprint. But it's a great run by Keita. He's an exceptional athlete, as are all the Kenyan runners. And Olympic champion.
They keep pulling them out, don't they, the Kenyans, especially at this event?
Well, I mean, they're great natural runners, but they're very versatile runners. Most of their runners can turn to the steeplechase really well. And a guy like Kip Tanui is a former world record holder at 3,000 and 5,000 metres on the flat.
Yep.
So when you take that sort of speed into the steeplechase, it's a wonderful combination. Mm.
We've got the women's 10,000 coming up. China?
Wang Yongsia, probably. She's already won the 5,000. She's world record holder for the 10,000 and 5,000. She won the world championships in 1993 and then disappeared. But Dorota Tulu from Ethiopia, she won the gold medal in Barcelona. And, you know, I mean, Ethiopia have had a great games. Gabri Selassie won the 10. Fatuma Roba from Ethiopia won the women's marathon. So, I mean, maybe Tulu will put up a bit of a battle, but Wang Yongsia certainly looks pretty exceptional.
They've got more medals than us, Ethiopia, haven't they? Not more medals, but more gold medals.
More gold medals. Every single medal that Ethiopia have ever won, I think it's something like 15 now, have been done by distance runners.
Yes.
A baby Bikila back in 1960, and a Mama Waldi, Mirichift, and it goes on and on. And Dorota Tulu, when she won the 10,000 in Barcelona, that was the first black African woman to win a distance. And Fatuma Robo's marathon win was the first black woman to win a marathon, Olympic marathon. So they've, you know, they're pretty much the pace setters.
I saw you talking to Gebre Selassie. Was it this morning or yesterday morning again? Who won the 10,000 metres, but pulled out of the 5,000 metres. Was he explaining to you why exactly that happened?
He popped in here, actually, and we had a bit of a chat. But, yeah, he's got really sore legs. I mean, he broke the Olympic record for the 10,000 and the world record for the slowest lap at the end of the race. He was shattered. And his feet have been wrecked by that. And it's interesting that I think there's only two people from the 10,000 attempted to have a go in the 5,000 as well, which is really unusual because many people have a go in both.
Okay, before we have